Hello students, today we are going to learn about trigonometric ratios. Before we begin with trigonometric ratios, I'd like to give you a brief introduction of what is trigonometry. Trigonometry comes from the Greek word trigonon. T-R-I, tri means three, gonia, G-O-N-I-A means angle, and matron means measurement. All these three words put together, we get the word trigonometry. So trigonometry is about measurement of a triangle. So it's about the direct application of trigonometry is solving a triangle. So a triangle involves six elements, three angles and three sides. When you are given three of these six elements, we can find the other three elements that using the concepts of trigonometry. And trigonometry, it has a lot of practical applications in physical and earth sciences. And we are going to, in particular, look at right-angled triangle or right triangle, because all three sides in a right triangle have special names. And I'm going to first name the right triangle, the sides of the right triangle, and then we are going to look at the trigonometric ratios. The trigonometric ratios is nothing but the relationship between the three angles and the three sides of a right-angled triangle. Alright, let's begin with naming the right angle triangle. Here is a right angle triangle, right angled at B. I have named the right angle triangle as ABC. Here, let me take this angle, angle CAB, as theta. Right? The side opposite to angle A or angle theta, what is that side? BC. Here, BC is called the opposite side of angle A. The remaining side AB is adjacent next to angle theta or angle A, right? So AB is called the adjacent side of angle A. Adjacent side of angle A. The longest side here is AC, and AC is called the hypotenuse. So AC, the longest side, is called the hypotenuse. Now we know the special names of the three sides of a right angle triangle. Now in a right angle triangle, we can come up with possibly six possible ratios using the sides. That is what we are going to look at now, one by one. Like I said, trigonometric ratios are nothing but the relationship between the sides and angles of a right angle triangle. Right. Now let's begin with the first trigonometric ratio. The trigonometric ratio connecting the opposite side and the hypotenuse, BC and AC, is termed as sine of angle A. Sine, S-I-N-E, of angle A. We can simply, instead of writing it as S-I-N-E, we usually, while solving problems, use SIN, sine of angle A. And what is that equal to? Opposite side by hypotenuse. The side opposite to angle A by the length of the hypotenuse. So here it is BC by AC. Second one, the side connecting the adjacent side and the opposite side of a right angle triangle. What is that ratio known as? Cosine A. C-O-S-I-N-E-A. Or for convenience, while solving problems, we simply write it as cos A. And what is cos A? The ratio of the adjacent side to the hypotenuse. AB divided by AC. What is the next possibility? Here we connected the opposite side and hypotenuse. Here we connected the adjacent side and hypotenuse. Next, what do we get if I connect the opposite and adjacent side? So we get tangent of A, angle A. For convenience, while solving problems, we refer to it as tan A. And what is tan A? Opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite side of angle A divided by adjacent side of angle A. If you observe, BC by AB is nothing but BC by AC divided by AB by AC. So the AC in the denominator will get cancelled when you divide this by this ratio, right? Or I can say that tan A is equal to sin A by cos A. I had actually told you that we can come up with 6 possible trigonometric ratios using the 3 sides, right? Now we have already looked at 3 of them. What are the remaining 3? We will be focusing on the multiplicative inverses of each one of them here. Sine, cos and tan of angle A. The multiplicative inverse of sine A is referred to as cosecant A. Cosecant A, simply, you know, we call it as cosecant, C-O-S-E-C. We just drop there and then put the angle, is equal to the inverse of sine A. What is sine A? Opposite side by hypotenuse. So what will this be, cosecant A? Hypotenuse by opposite side. What is the hypotenuse here? AC. What is the opposite side here? BC. Now, what is the multiplicative inverse of cosine A? That is referred to as secant A. We simply call it SEC, secant A. And what is that equal to? 1 by cos A. What is cos A? Cos A or cosine A is nothing but adjacent side by hypotenuse. Therefore, secant A will be hypotenuse by adjacent side. What is the hypotenuse in our triangle? AC. What is the adjacent side? AB. Finally, the multiplicative inverse of tangent A is called as cotangent A. The short form of cotangent A is simply cot A. So what is cot A equal to? 1 by tan A. But what is actually tan A? Opposite side by adjacent side. So the inverse would be adjacent side by opposite side. What is the adjacent side here? AB. And the opposite side? BC. I hope the 6 trigonometric ratios were clear. Sine A is opposite side by hypotenuse. Cos A, adjacent side by hypotenuse. Tan A, opposite side by adjacent side. Cosecant A, the inverse of sine A, which is hypotenuse by opposite side. Secant A, which is the multiplicative inverse of cosine A, is equal to the adjacent hypotenuse by adjacent side. And finally, cotangent A, which is the multiplicative inverse of tan A, which is equal to adjacent side by opposite side. I hope the 6 ratios were clear.